Here's a challenge for you. I want you to get this hard-boiled egg inside this bottle without breaking it. How would you do it? Today, we will find the answer to this riddle and learn so much more with my experiment, Egg in a Bottle. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab, and on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab those eggs because we're about to learn the answer to this riddle. For this one, you need some hard-boiled eggs, a glass milk bottle, some coupon paper from the mail, scissors, and a lighter. Parents and adults, because we are using a lighter, make sure we are exercising caution here. The first thing you want to do is take your coupon paper and cut a 2-inch by 4-inch piece of paper out, just like this. And then what we are going to do, this is all gonna happen very quickly, you guys. We are going to fold up our paper because we want this to be able to go inside of our glass bottle. And what we're gonna do is light this end of our coupon paper, and once it's on fire, we are going to throw it in our bottle and then very quickly put our egg on top. We're gonna leave this in the bottle. I'm gonna drop it in, right? And then I'm gonna leave the egg right on top. And then we'll see what happens, okay? You ready? This is one of my favorite ones. Let's light this on fire in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Fire! Egg! Egg is bouncing around, woohoo! And that is our egg in a bottle. That's perfect, look at that. It is completely whole, not a crack in sight. So what happened there? How did that work and why did it work so quickly? That was amazing, right? So what we did is we lit our coupon paper on fire and we threw it in. That heated the air inside of our bottle. And when air gets hot, it wants to what? Take up more space. Right? So when we put our egg on top, we saw it bounce around. It was bouncing around. That was the air molecules escaping from the bottle around the egg, jostling it around a little bit. But the egg created a seal on the opening right here. That prevented any additional oxygen from getting into our bottle, making the flame go out because the flame needs oxygen and we were starving it of oxygen. And once that happened, the air started to cool down. What do we know about cold air? When air gets cold, it wants to take up less space. So we had a low pressure environment in here and a high pressure atmospheric environment, and that forced our egg into the bottle. That is how you solved the riddle. And you might be thinking, do we create a vacuum that sucked in the egg? But vacuums don't suck, air pushes. We just created a very low pressure environment in our bottle so that the outer atmospheric pressure that was stronger pushed in the egg into the bottle. So now you might ask, how do you get the egg out, right? Well, one thing that you can do, and I've done this before, is you would create a seal of the egg. You kind of have to get the paper out first. Let me do that. So you create a seal of the egg at the opening right here, and you can use the same science to get the egg out that you did to get it in. You would just need to make a perfect seal of the egg and the opening and heat up the air inside the bottle. I've done this once. I highly do not recommend this because it's a little bit dangerous. You could use a blowtorch and blowtorch the glass so that the air inside heated up so much that the air pressure got so large and it forced the egg out of a bottle. But what you could also do, and here's the real recommendation because this is the easy way, is to get a butter knife, chop up your egg, and just shake out the guts. Not a super glamorous process, but it works. There you go. Okay, let's try that with our other eggs. So this one worked really well. And just word to the wise, smaller eggs obviously work better here. If you try just like a slightly medium-sized egg, it will break upon entering. It'll still go in. We had two here. They still both went in fully, but they both broke in the process. It was just too violent for a little bit of a larger egg. So if you have smaller eggs, this experiment will work like it's supposed to. Thanks for getting an egg and a bottle with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.